Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. We are welcome to this meeting this morning. Pastor Amino, please can we have the opening prayer?
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Let us go to the Lord in prayer. Father in heaven, thank you for this day. Thank you for the gift of life. Thank you for your mercies. God, new every morning, we give you praise, King of glory. We worship you and honor you for being a faithful God and merciful God unto us. We want to commit this hour in your presence, Lord, before your throne of grace. We ask that you bless us, Lord, with your presence. We ask that you speak to our hearts, O Lord, this morning, even as we prepare to go into the day, that your presence will go with us. You go ahead of us and make the crooked way straight for us in the name of Jesus Christ. We ask that you order our steps, Lord, today in the way that we should go. And speak to our hearts once more this morning, even as we are before you this day. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Amen. Let us continue as we worship the Lord together with the songs. Hallelujah.
Be glorified. Be glorified. Be glorified. Be glorified.
Be glorified.
Be glorified.
In our hearts, Lord.
Be. Oh,
shall rise to thee. Holy, 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 merciful and mighty, God in three persons, blessed Trinity.
To our general prayers this morning. Pastor Jesus will be leading us.
Amen. Let us pray. Father, we worship you, Lord. We give you glory and honor and praise. We lift up high your name above every name, O Lord. And we say, Father, forever be exalted in our lives. In Jesus' name, amen. This morning, our prayers is focused on our marriages. Our prayers are focused on our marriages. If you're not married, you can still pray for the marriages on the platform, or you can pray that God blesses you with your own marriage also. Our first prayer is, Heavenly Father, I come before you thanking you for all you have done and continue to do in my life and marriage. Again, Father, thank you. Father, Heavenly Father, I come before you, thanking you for all you have done and continue to do in my life and marriage. Let us pray, saints. Oh, our Lord and our God, Father, this morning we thank you, O God. This morning we give you all the glory. We thank you, we worship you, we honor you, we adore you, O God. We thank you for all you have done, O Lord, for our marriages, O God. Thank you, Lord, for all you have done and continue to do in my life and in my marriage, O God. Father, you created marriage, O God. Marriage is your institution, O God. It's Lord, and we thank you, O God, that, Lord, you support and you uphold our marriages, O God. Thank you for all you do in my life and in my marriage, O God. Father, be glorified in my marriage, Jehovah. Be magnified in my life, O God. And my marriage, and give you glory, with God. Thank you in Jesus' name. Now, our prayer number two. I said, Father, I lift up and commit my marriage to you today, asking that you would give us, me and my spouse, a fresh hunger for seeking your truth, both individually and as a couple. I said, Father, Lord, I lift up, let us pray. Father, I lift up, oh Lord, and commit my marriage to you today, asking that you give me and Joseph and Sian, my wife, oh God, a fresh hunger, oh Lord, for seeking your truth, both individually and as a couple, oh God. Lord, you place your desire in us, O God. You place your spirit in us, O God. You cause us to hunger for you, O God. Lord, this morning our prayer is that, Father, I lift up and commit my marriage to you, O God, asking that, Lord, you would give me and my wife, Josephine Siangjud Abraham, O God, a fresh hunger for seeking your truth, O God. Lord Jesus, both individually and as a couple, O God. Lord, we are trusting you, O God. We lift up and we commit our marriage in your hands, O God. We said, Father, rise up, O God. Lord, I ask that you would give us, me and my wife, O God. Oh, Lord, a fresh hand for seeking your truth, O God, both individually and as a couple. Father, I lift up and commit my marriage to you today, asking that you would give us, me and my wife, Josephine Siangjud Abraham, a fresh hunger for seeking you, O God. Thank you in the name of Jesus Christ. Now, our prayer number three, we said, Heavenly Father, heal our hearts of past hurts and wounds and help us to trust in you and one another. In the name of Jesus Christ, let us pray. Father, this morning, Heavenly Father, heal our hearts, O God, of past hurts and wounds, and heal us, me and my wife, O God. Heal us, O God, Lord, and help us to trust in you and one another again. Oh, Father, your word says, O God, that, Lord, you on the day when the lights are shined, when you shall bind the bleaches of the people and heal their wounds, O God, thy light shall shine seven times brighter. Oh God, we said, Father, heal our hearts, O God. Heal Joseph and I, our hearts, O God. Heal the hearts of me and my wife of every past hurts and wounds, and help us to trust in you one another again, O God. Refresh us, O God. Pour out your love into us afresh, O God. Reignite that love in us one more time, O God. Oh, Father, we said from the beginning of creation, God made male and female, O God. Father, you make male and female, O God. And he said, for this shall cause a man to leave his family and the woman, and they shall be one together. And that which you have put together, let no man put asunder. Father, this morning, O God, heal our hearts, O God. Heal the hearts of every wife and husband on this platform, O God. Father, heal my marriage, O God. Myself and my wife, Josephine Shell, O God. Heal our hearts and our wounds, O God. And Lord Jehovah, bring us together. Heal us in the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Now, our prayer number four. We said, Father, I'm asking that you help us, me and my wife, yes, by your grace, to be united front, that nothing come between us. Help us to identify and work through anything that is not pleasing to you, so we can continually reach higher levels of unity in our marriage, spiritually, physically, and mentally. Amen. Let us pray. Father, Lord God Almighty, this morning I am asking that you help me and my wife, Josephine Siangina Brown, help us by your grace to be united front, that nothing can between us. Help us to identify and work through anything that is not pleasing to you, so we can continually reach higher levels of unity in our marriage, spiritually, physically, and mentally, O God. Oh, Father, you are the God that created marriages, O God. You are the God that supports marriages, O God. Father, this morning we are asking you, God, help me and my wife, Josephine Siangina Brown, God, by your grace, to be united front, God. Nothing come between us, God. Help us, God, to identify and to work through anything that is not pleasing to you, so we can continually reach higher levels of unity in our marriage, spiritually, physically, and mentally, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, God. Oh, Father, thou art the creator of marriage, sir. We worship you, we thank you, we bless you, God. We say, Father, I'm asking that you help us, me and my wife, Josephine, God, by your grace, to be a united front. Thank you, in Jesus' name we pray. Now, our prayer number five. We said, Father, Heavenly Father, as we, me and my spouse, strive to continually build a stronger marriage, help us, oh God, to forgive one another for things that may hurt or offend us. Help us to walk in forgiveness and never lose sight of the fact that you forgive us first. Again, open your mouth and let us pray. Say, Heavenly Father, oh Jehovah God Almighty, Lord, ask me and my wife, Josephine Siawa, God, strive to continually build a stronger marriage. Help us to forgive one another. Help us to forgive one another. Help us to forgive one another, O God. Help us, Jehovah, to forgive one another for things that may hurt or offend us, O God. Help us to walk in forgiveness and never lose sight of that fact that you, Jehovah God Almighty, you forgive us first, O God. Oh, my Lord and my God, this morning, O God, I lift up myself and my wife, Josephine Siang, in your hands, O God. Oh, Lord, I say, as we strive to continually build a stronger marriage, O God, help us to forgive one another for things that may hurt or offend us, O God. Help to walk in forgiveness and never, O God, hold each other. Thank you in Jesus' name. Father, now our prayer number six, we say, Heavenly Father, please show us, my spouse and I, any behavior that we have been committing that has been preventing us from entering into a deeper, intimate relationship with you and one another. We say, Heavenly Father, please show us, my spouse, yes, any behavior we have been committing that has been preventing us from entering into a deeper, intimate relationship with you and one another. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, this morning, O God, we are bringing myself and my spouse to face you before you, O God. We say, Father, please help us, O God. Help us, O God, in any behavior we have been committing that has been preventing us from entering into a deeper, intimate relationship with you and one another. Help us, Jehovah. Lord, you are the helper of marriage, O God. Marriages belong to you, O God. Marriage is a holy, sanctified thing unto you, O God. Help me and my spouse, Josephine, and any behavior we have been committing that has been preventing us from entering into a deeper, intimate relationship with you and one another. Help us, O Jehovah, Lord. Help us, O God. Let not the enemy consume our marriage, O God. Let not the enemy infiltrate our marriage, O God. Help us, Jehovah, any behavior we have been committing that has been preventing us from entering into a deeper, intimate relationship with you and one another. Help us, God. You said you are our shield and our present help. Lord, help us, God. He said, Lord, if we confess our sins, He is faithful and just to forgive us from all our sins. Father, you are a just God. Help us, God. Help help us, Jehovah. You are the God that created marriage, God. Help us, God. Father, show us, me and my spouse, any behavior we have been committing that is not right. Show it to us in Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. Now, our prayer number 7. We said, Father, Heavenly Father, I am asking you today to strengthen the bonds between us, O God. That the physical and spiritual intimacy in our marriage will be stronger than ever. In the name of Jesus Christ, let us pray. Heavenly Father, I am asking you today, O God. Oh, I am asking you today to strengthen the bonds between us, me and my wife, Josephine, O God. Strengthen the bond between us, O God, that the physical and spiritual intimacy in our marriage will be stronger than ever before. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, oh Lord, help us, God. He said, for this cause shall a man leave his father and mother, and shall be joined unto his wife, and then shall be one flesh, of God. Lord, help me. I'm asking today, help me and my wife, of God. Help us in Jesus' name, of God, oh, to build a stronger bond between us, of God. Lord, truly make us one flesh, of God, one in mind, one in spirit, one in everything, of God. Lord, bring agreement between us, of God. Let us be one in agreement, of God. Give us that spirit of agreement, of God. Let the physical and spiritual be together in Jesus' name. Now, our prayer number 8. We said, Father, Father, this morning, of God, Heavenly Father, help us, of God, to be the husband and wife you have intended me, oh God, to be. Show me where I need to improve. Help me to be a better spouse. Help me to love my wife or husband better. And help us both to grow closer to you and to each other. In Jesus' name we pray. Now let us pray. Heavenly Father, Jehovah God Almighty, help me to be a better husband to Josephine Sion, to Abraham, my wife, of God. Oh, yes, you have intended me to be. Show me where I need to improve. Help me to be a better husband, of God. Help me to love my wife, Josephine Sion, oh, better, of God. And help us, oh God, both to grow closer to you and each other. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Oh, Father, help us, of God. Help us, of God. Oh, Lord, help us in the name of Jesus Christ, of God. Now, Father, help us. Be our helper, Jehovah. Oh, my Lord and my God. Help me to be a better husband to my wife, Josephine, oh God. Help me to be a better husband. Thank you in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Glory to God. Father, we thank you again this morning for all the marriages represented on this platform. Let your peace be established in everyone in the name of Jesus. Glory to God. And anyone here trusting you to have his or her marriage established that is looking forward to such a blessing, you that know the path in the seas and make a way in the mighty waters, Lord, make such a way real this year. In Jesus' name. Now we'll proceed to scriptural reading, and we'll be reading from Isaiah 66, 7 to 14. Isaiah 66, 7 to 14. Sister Shei will read for us. Over to you, please.
Good morning. Isaiah 66, 7 through 14. Before the birth pains even begin, yeah. Jerusalem gives birth to a son. Who has ever seen or heard of anything as strange as this? Has a nation ever been born in a single day? Has a country ever come forth in a mere moment? But by the time Jerusalem's birth pains begin, the baby will be born. The nation will come forth. Would I ever bring this nation to the point of birth and then not deliver it? Asked the Lord. No, I would never keep this nation from being born, says your God. Rejoice with Jerusalem. Be glad with her. All you who love her and mourn for her, delight in Jerusalem. Drink deeply of her glory, even as an infant drinks at its mother's generous breasts. Peace and prosperity will overflow Jerusalem like a river, says the Lord. The wealth of the nations will flow to her. Her children will be nursed at her breasts, carried in her arms and treated with love. I will comfort you there as a child is comforted by its mother. When you see these things, your heart will rejoice. Vigorous health will be yours. Everyone will see the good hand of the Lord on his people and his anger against his enemies. This is the word of the Lord.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. Jesus is Lord. Today, as we have been doing since the beginning of this week, like I said, this is our Kenyan week. And I did that because I've been a missionary to a few countries and I have tentacles in all those places. Kenya is one of them. Today we have one of my daughters also in the ministry. She will be ministering to us. Her name is Apostle Miriam. And I'm going to hand over to her now that she should bless us with the word of God. Over to you. You have to unmute yourself. Unmute yourself.
Okay.
Okay.
Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the living God. My name is Apostle Merab. I love the Lord Jesus as my personal Savior. And I thank God, Daddy, Reverend Tunji, for giving me this opportunity today. Well, in my country, I'm in Nairobi, Kenya. Here it is afternoon at around 2:20 or so. We thank God for this wonderful morning glory, morning devotion that has been going on at Denver, US. And we have been blessed from various points that we have been attending. And this afternoon or this morning, I have the privilege to be able to share with us shortly or briefly the word of God. And I am delighted and I'm also humbled to be able to be given this opportunity. Well, we have read the book of Isaiah chapter 66, and the word of God says that can a nation be born just at once? Say, before a nation is born, there must be a birthing. Hallelujah. And before a bad thing, there must be travail. Say that there are many people who want God to show up in their lives. Many of us want God to show up in their in our lives in many ways. And I want to say that is right, because in the book of Genesis chapter 1, from chapter 1, verse 28 says, and that God, having created them, made the man and woman, he said, he blessed them and said, be fruitful and multiply. And I want to share here that God has bestowed upon the children of God, the servants of God, and I mean all of us as servants of God here. We thank God for all for these. God has bestowed upon us, in each one of us, very great things. Great destinies are within us that are awaiting to be unleashed, that are waiting to be released for the purposes of God, for the sake of the kingdom of God. Now, God now comes in Isaiah and says that these purposes must be birthed. Hallelujah. These purposes must be birthed. And before they are birthed, there has to be travail. Many a times, we go through so many travails. But I'm here to tell you that many of the travails are for birthing out so many wonderful, great things that God has bestowed in us for the sake of his kingdom and for the sake of the purposes of our own lives. There are great things. The Bible says in 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 9, but as it is written, I has not seen, no ear heard, nor has it come to the heart of any man, those wonderful things that God has prepared for those who love him. And so me and you as and all of us as we are here, the love that we have for God, the Bible says that an angel in the book of Luke somewhere in chapter 1, I believe it's chapter 1, the Bible says that an angel went to a woman called Mary in Nazareth and told him, woman, Mary, the Lord is with you, because God has, you are favored among women. And Mary was disturbed about this and said, because it has pleased God that you are going to give birth Mary, you are going to give birth to a son. And this son, the name shall be called Jesus, because he's going to be a son of God. And Bible says, and Mary said, how shall it be? Knowing, seeing that I have not known any man. A wonderful God. I mean, glory to Jesus. The Bible says an angel told him, Mary, this has nothing to do with your carnality. This has nothing to do with you, who you are. This has nothing, Mary, to do with your background. This has nothing to do with every other manner of environment where you live. Mary, this has nothing to do with your flesh. Say, the Holy Ghost shall come over you. When the Holy Ghost will come over you, you shall be overshadowed by the power of the Holy Spirit. And so I want to tell us that in the presence of God, like now, even as we are enjoying the presence of God through the servant of God, Reverend Tunji, there's a lot of conception that happens in the presence of God, beloved. And these conceptions are there for the purposes of the things of God. Hallelujah. The Bible says that when the Holy Ghost overshadows you, then there is, comes a conception. And I want to tell us that God has a lot of things that wants to be birthed, that need to be birthed. Nations, generations and generations. We can remember the times of Rebecca. Bible said two nations are within your womb. So God doesn't see the things that you carry within you. He doesn't see them. He doesn't see them as just little. He never saw the little babies in Rebecca as just human beings. He said, "You, Rebecca, you are carrying nations." And the Bible says that, and the old shall serve the younger. So this is how God is speaking in us and through the deposit that he has placed in each one of us. And I want to believe that each one of us are placed in every manner of places from all walks of life for a purpose, for a divine purpose. Hallelujah. You are not where you are by a mistake. God has purpose, and there is something that is going to be unleashed out of each one of us for greatly. For the purposes of God. Hallelujah. When the young man called Joseph, God deposited, God gave him a conception through dreams. The Bible says, and he started dreaming how he would be a leader one time. Hallelujah. This young man, the journey for the unleashing, the destiny of Joseph, we know, we all know the journey, how it went. It took some time. All the manner of things that were happening to this young man, Joseph, including being sold to the Chaldeans, being taken to Egypt, slavery in Potiphar's house, all that time there was a deposit in this man, a deposit of being a great man that was gonna save the children of Israel, that was going to save the people of Israel in the due time. Bible says when the due time came, praise the living God. I want to tell us that there's a lot of great things that are in us. The Bible says in Isaiah 68, who has heard that a nation can be born at once? He says there must be travail. And he says, God is asking, can I, oh God, bring conception and fail to bring forth? He's asking. Hallelujah. Because somehow the children of Israel thought that the things of God were just going to happen in a carnal way, in the manner like the way Jesus said. You know, there's a time Jesus, the people asked Jesus, the crowd asked him, shall the kingdom of God come now, you know, so that we can be able to take over the government and be able to be over our enemies? And Jesus told them, the kingdom of God will not come the way you think. They say the kingdom of God is within you. And so the way God is asking, do you think that the way I do my things is the way you people take things, you know, casually? He say that I cannot bring conception. I'm God. I cannot bring conception and refuse or fail to bring to birth. I want to tell you a short story, just a short story for us to reflect on this. When a woman wants to give birth, and I identify with this so much because I'm a woman. When a woman's time for birthing comes, a woman who has been, has been pregnant for 9 months, when the time of birthing comes and there is no pain, hallelujah. Maybe some of us here can be able to reflect with this. When they go to the doctor asks, is there pain? when there is pain is detected, not there. There is something that a doctor does. He does what is called inducement. The woman is induced. And I want to tell you, the pain that comes with this injection is greater than any normal pain that would otherwise come in the normal delivery. Praise the living God. And so I want to say that there are some of the things that have been bestowed in us, some of the things that God has bestowed in you, great purposes of God, great things, that when the time of birthing comes, hallelujah, there are times that God must induce you. God must put in you, inject you with some inducement, with some pain. Because when the time of birthing comes, my brother, my sister, a birthing has to take place. If the birthing doesn't take place in the right time, the baby might die. The woman might die even with the baby. So what God does in us, he has bestowed upon us great things, great nations, great generations, great purposes, great ministries. But now time comes for birthing. And sometimes, my brother, my sister, you are not even aware. You did not plan for certain things to happen to you, but they will happen anyway, because God has to induce you so that you bring forth great things that God has purpose to be brought forth in the ministry, in the kingdom of God. And I love God for this, because this, it is only a true birthing that brings forth true purposes of God. It's only in true birthing that true great things, great ministries come forth. And sometimes I say this, praise the living God. Sometimes I say this, those people who bring forth the true purposes of God, they don't have time to fight other ministers. They have no room. They have no time to fight, because they have genuine babies. They have genuine purposes of God. You have no room. You have no space to go fight another person, whether they are genuine or not. You are busy nurturing your baby. May God give you babies today in the name of Jesus. May God bring forth through you today. In the name of Jesus, I just believe that this program is not in vain. There are great things that God is using his servant, Reverend Tunji, to bring forth through us, through the children of God that God has placed under him. And I want to tell you, God is continuing to ask in Isaiah that, can I bring pain and cause to bring forth? And I'm here to tell you, any pain that you ever went through, or any pain that you may go through, it is a good pain. The Bible says in James chapter 1 verse 2 that, beloved, count it all joy when you go through diverse temptations, knowing that the trying of your faith yield for it great patience, and patience now bring forth perfection, you wanting nothing anymore. I want to say that after the delivery, you will, the Bible says in John chapter 16 verse 21, Bible says, Jesus says that now you are grieving. The Bible says that, but when a woman wants to give birth, she grieves so much, she travails, because the anguish, the pain is so much. But once the baby is born, the joy that comes, nobody can take away from her. And I can identify with this. After delivery, you feel joy and you feel love. You want to love everybody. May God bestow that love upon you even when you're going through situations. This afternoon, I want to share that God is able to bring forth great things that he has bestowed upon you. Bible says that the angel told Mary, Mary, this has nothing to do with your power. This has nothing to do with your money. This has nothing to do with your carnality. This has all to do with the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost will be able to bring forth the baby for himself. I want to say that God is able, who called each one of us, is able to bring us to birthing, and is able to bring forth the babies within us, and is able to use them for his glory. Hallelujah, in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Time is up. God bless you so much. Let me pray. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I thank you for the word that you have brought unto us, King of Glory, that you have used me to share with us. I thank you for your servant, Reverend Tunji. Thank you for everyone that was on board. Thank you for every great thing that you're doing in us. Thank you, Lord. I pray that may there be a true birthing out of this fellowship today. In Jesus' name I pray. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. I love you. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Glory to God. Thank you.
Glory to God.
Thank you.
He said, before she traveled, she brought forth. Before her pain came off her, she was delivered of a man's side. He said, what has such a thing?
Amen.
The a time of release now.
Amen.
Those discomfort, those challenges.
Yes.
They are to straighten you. He said, how is it if it is, how am I if it is straightened? Not stretched, yes. Straightened.
Amen.
Faith is always tried.
Yes.
But the beauty of it is God said it very clearly in this verse we read. He said, shall I bring to birth? That means you are in the state of pain to deliver and not cause you to bring forth. God will allow you to go through all that just for the purpose of suffering. No.
Amen.
Because something great is in you that must be delivered.
Amen.
And those who know him, stay true with it.
Amen.
Those who know him, don't give up on him. No.
Amen.
Those who know him know the darker it is, then the day is about to be, you know, the dawn is about to break. So you are breaking forth. Put your faith all out. It's not just, oh, what is going on about me? It's never closed.
Yes.
Until God says so, never. So you never see the challenges all around you, the discomfort or whatever, and then give up that it's over with me. No, God has faith in you that your world will celebrate. And it's your time to reform. God is waiting on you. He said, as soon as Zion travailed, she brought forth. There's so much with the word travail, but time is not there. It's time to go before the Lord. This is the moment of travailing us. In prayers, in intercession, in tears of pain before the Lord. Don't not say tears of pain before me. That God, this is my hour of release. This time I must bring forth. In our personal moment, because the next chapter here is to go into a personal moment and point out. Remember what Anna said. She said, I'm a woman of a sorrowful spirit. I've only poured out my soul before the Lord. We need to know how to do that, because you never do that and return the same. It's not possible. It takes it off and brings a new life is born, just like Samuel was born. So let's go before the Lord. Whatever is it you want to present to the Lord this morning, say to him, cry to him in whatever form, this is that moment. Go before the Lord and express it all to him, and we'll be back together shortly.
Worship you, Jesus. We give you honor. We give you praise. Your name is holy, Jehovah God. We declare we shall bring forth. We declare we must bring forth. Thank you.
Hallelujah. Let's begin to round our prayers this morning. Glory to God. Glory to God. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you. In the name of Jesus. There's one thing I want us to do today, may not be for everybody, I believe. There are some here whose marriages are in trouble, and that's the truth. When I was putting these prayers together, the Lord laid this in my heart directly, and I put it separate. And I need such ones to go with all sincerity before the Lord right now. And any other of us without troubled marriage, just pray for every troubled marriage on this platform. In this moment, but for those who you know, your marriage is in trouble, I need you to go before the Lord right now and say, Father, I come to you with a heavy heart, because that's what it is. And be open, bold enough to say, Lord, I know my marriage is in trouble. I need your help. Touch our hearts, Lord of heaven. Touch our hearts and by your own hand, bring us together again. And fill our hearts. The Bible says, for the love of God has been shed abroad in our hearts by the Holy Ghost that is given to us. And fill our hearts with your love, giving us the strength, because you have lost the strength to love each other again. You've lost that strength. It's just not there. Things have just been broken down. That's what the Holy Ghost showed me. Just broken down. That there's no way. You can see how it goes. Go before the Lord right now and pray that prayer. Fill our hearts again with your love and give us the strength to love one another or each other and care for ourselves to fulfill our God-ordained destiny. Lord, my marriage is in trouble. I need your help. And the first thing is, Lord, touch our hearts. When it comes to the hearts of men, that's God's territory. It just looks like this woman can't flow with me again, or this man can't flow with me again. It's broken. But Lord, I need your help. Touch our hearts and bring it back together. You that brought dead bones to life, no, you can't do this. Just go before the Lord, and the rest of us, very briefly, don't say, oh, my own is okay. Let's just pray for every troubled marriage here, because his divorce is not God's will. Just 1 minute, do that quickly, and we'll be closing. Glory to God. Thank you, Father. Let God hear you. It's part of the travail. Take that pain of distorted, broken, perhaps scattered marriage, and go before the Lord as one that is delivering today. The Lord put this in my heart for you, and he won't do that if he has nothing to do in bringing it together. He won't do that. It's because he has you in mind to bring it together in a way that most or many people will be amazed. How can this happen? It was over. It's never over. Take that pain. Lord, I need help. Open up yourself before the Lord. I need help. I'm in trouble. Help me. Glory to God. Thank you, Father. Thank you, most excellent one. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for all the marriages on this platform. Lord, I bring them all before you. That's all. Pay attention and help us in the name of Jesus. Lord, for every troubled marriage, you know who they are. When you gave me these, you know exactly all those that you have in mind this morning. And I'm saying, Lord of heaven, in the Bible says, when you give a quietness, who can break trouble? Oh, King of glory, let your peace secure these marriages again. But circumcise the hearts of these spouses to themselves. In the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of God, I speak peace to these marriages. You are the waves and the storm boisterous. But by just one word of peace, calmness came. You are the one who knows the heart of man. Lord, touch their hearts. Touch their hearts right now, the husband, the wife, in a way that nobody can. In a way that only you can. Touch their hearts as I pray right now. in the name of Jesus and bring them together again by the working of your own hand that nobody can contest in the name of Jesus. But I speak peace to them today. Take these words of peace and walk their peace in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, in Jesus' name. Amen. Glory to God. Remember, this program runs Monday through Fridays, 5 a.m. Mountain Time. We'll be back on this platform tomorrow with another moment of refreshing before the Lord. But today, those pains, God is translating them to a delivery for you that your word will celebrate. It's not over. It's just another moment, another new moment being given back to your life. In the name of Jesus. Take those words and celebrate all through today that I know my story has changed. A new thing is born. A new glory is delivered because that is what God does. It is well with you this morning. And the ministers we've had since Monday, we still have one more from Kenya tomorrow. God, I know, I've prayed it, that the hand of the Lord will be multiplied upon their lives. And the ministry that God has committed into their hands, we keep flourishing, moving from glory to glory, from strength to strength, from faith to faith, in the name of Jesus. So, Apostle Miriam, God bless you. You are highly favored. Your pains have been converted to testimonies this morning, in the name of Jesus. Peace to everyone hearing me. Go forth today, enjoying the goodness of God in your life. The peace of God goes with you. In the name of Jesus. Let's share the goodness together this morning. Tomorrow is another day. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen. God bless you. See you in a glorious day tomorrow morning. Jesus is Lord.